The Philippine Space Agency teams up with several government agencies to use space-related technologies for socio-economic development. To tell us more about this, we have with us PhilSA Director General Dr. Joel Marchano Jr. Doctor, thank you for joining us on the program.
Thank you. Good afternoon, Rica. It's great to be with you.
Hi, our pleasure having you with us, Doctor. Let's start first with space tech already being used now. This is not the first time that we've heard this, but with the recent typhoons with Egay and Falcon just passing us by, how integral did we see space tech was in government efforts?
Well, it is quite integral. It is an emerging capability that we're learning to take advantage of now. Because what's immediately being done in the face of these typhoons is to prepare pre-typhoon images and then the post-typhoon images over the affected areas. Then we use algorithms, even artificial intelligence, to do the so-called change detection, which leads us to a better and quicker picture of the extent of damage. So in terms of early warning, satellite images help map areas that are vulnerable to natural hazards, so-called disaster hotspots. Now, to predict something, we need to use plenty of computation or computer modeling. And what the satellites provide are images and data that are inputs to these computations. And PAGASA uses satellite observations to monitor weather patterns, the projected path of typhoons, the estimated strength, together with other instruments like radar. They can try to estimate the amount or volume of moisture or rain that they bring. So I believe we've adopted as a country a scenario-based approach, and this is work in progress. We're also aiming for prevention. Mm-hmm. Now, that is to prevent or minimize adverse effects by not building on, say, identified disaster hotspots and improving building codes and managing risks better.
Mm-hmm. If you may give us a quick rundown, Doctor, which agencies and departments of the government are you currently in partnership with now?
Okay. Well, first, there's the Department of Environment and Natural Resources. We signed a memorandum of agreement with them in order to do baselining of natural resources in the country and for the National Greening Program. Just last week, during Philippine Space Week launch, we signed agreements with various government agencies. We see, first of all, the breadth or variety of the agencies involved in these agreements. We're partnering with, from fisheries and vessel activity with BFAR, Bureau of Fisheries Aquatic Resources, project monitoring of Build Better More with the Department of Budget and Management, infrastructure development with the Mindanao Development Authority. There's agricultural financing, insurance, and risk assessment with the Land Bank of the Philippines, air quality monitoring with DNR and the Korea International Cooperation Agency. So these agreements are mostly partnering up so we can derive insights from satellite images and start to operationalize them. Mm-hmm. Now, to do that, we build absorptive, organic capacity within these groups so that they can access the data, and then we provide training, and we exchange know-how, and they, more importantly, they provide feedback. So in a nutshell, I can say these partnerships are really about being space being integral now to digital transformation and governance. And these partnerships highlight that.
Mm-hmm. It's nice to see that you're working with a lot of agencies that's able to at least assist so many Filipinos when it comes to, their daily life, even on their work itself, on how we do our profession. But let's look at how space technology can further assist in the development of, number one, climate change adaptation, and number two, our weather applications. We're already using space tech on this, but how can we develop it further?
Well, we need the support of all of government. The top of my list is for government to be a pervasive user of space-based technologies, pretty much like ICTs, information communications technologies. Government should be a primary value adder of these capabilities. The space technologies cut across the work of all of government, and PhilSA is trying to show the way forward. Let me say, though, that I believe we are on our way. These partnerships that we highlighted this week, we are seeing this absorption and appreciation of this capacity from various departments and agencies. Also, the president understands, President BBM understands the value of these technologies in nation building for socioeconomic development. And that's why August 8 to 14 was declared as Philippine Space Week every year through proclamation number 302. And now, as the government aims for digitalization and increased efficiencies, the bigger picture really involves the use of data and scientific evidence. And this can come from space, right? Satellites with their strategic vantage point. So therefore, the call is to use it, to promote it, and to invest in it further.
Doctor, if I'm not mistaken, I do know that the Philippines has launched several satellites before, Diwata and Maya. Am I right on that? Because I'd really want to know the development on satellite imaging, especially when we talk about policy decisions. If we look at how space tech can assist on some major issues, can we drill down on these, please? First, on mining, your thoughts on this, please.
Well, first of all, you mentioned building these satellites. First and foremost, this is really about our young people, giving them the experience and the hands-on, immersive, experiential tools, to build difficult technologies and expose them to the requirements of building reliable, high-value products. And that hopefully cascades, and we intend to cascade that to local industry, to building a local industrial base that can build high value products in the country. The applications are always there, right? But first and foremost, we have to also address the source of these data, the satellites themselves. Mm-hmm. Maybe not the entire satellites, but strategic components of it, like the cameras, certain components that we are building in Laguna, semiconductors, electronics. We want to space qualify them and also make them obtain so-called space heritage. That way, the value of these components increase more. Now, for mining, of course, there is the possibility of monitoring these areas by using satellite imagery, and that is already being done by DNR. Mm-hmm. So the way that PhilSat does these activities is to really work with different government agencies. We are, after all, a space agency, and there are other groups that take the insights obtained from space and they act on it. And that is important, like how DNR recently used satellite images together with information on the ground to shut down illegal mining sites. So this work will continue.
Of course, it's not just satellite imaging that we have to talk about. There's also the aspect of data analysis. What about on land reclamation activities? Do you have data? Do you have data on this that might be able to help the government?
This is the larger view is infrastructure monitoring, and that is being pursued. The same satellites that we use to monitor the construction of bridges, roads, airports, seaports, etc., can be used obviously to detect and to monitor these areas where we are doing land reclamation. So this information is being shared with relevant groups, including the DNR. So we're starting to leverage more our capabilities from our eyes in the sky.
All right, a last one before I let you go, Doctor. Every one of us as children starts with a fascination for space. Because it's Space Week, still a few days before Space Week ends, I'll give you time to at least invite the young generation or those who would still want to dabble on this to finally, open their doors for space tech.
Thank you. Well, Philippine Space Week is really about our young people and, of course, the young at heart. Everybody is really curious, and that's our strength. Now, we have a young workforce that's really curious and hoping to make a difference for the future. As is customary, any celebration has a theme. We have a theme. We call it Yamang Kalawakan Tungo sa Maunlad na Kinabukasan. And we basically invite everyone to join this call, to really strengthen Yamang Kalawakan. And Yamang Kalawakan refers to capabilities, resources, infrastructure, and space itself as a precious environment that benefits mankind and benefits Filipinos. So the call to action is to come together and let's all bring space closer to Filipinos and to everybody, because space, while it might seem literally distant, it really affects our daily lives through this global space economy.
All right. And as the famous astronaut Buzz Lightyear said, to infinity, development, and beyond. With that, I'll let you go. Thank you so much, Dr. Joel Marciano Jr., for your time. Have a good afternoon, Doctor. Thank you.
Thank you.